Here we are back on trail, Aloha Lake. Absolutely stunning. Here we are, we've made it up Dick's Pass. A little later in the day, but that's okay. We've only got about 2 miles left to where we're going to camp tonight, down by Dick's Lake. Another pass under your belt, Chloe.
Yes.
Well done.
Very happy.
So just packing up camp, getting ready to head out. This is our view this morning. The colours were absolutely incredible before. The lake out in the middle of there is South Lake Tahoe.
So I just come around the corner here to this view. Lake Tahoe. Another day on the PCT, currently at about mile 11:48. When we hit Donner Pass Road today, that's where we will say goodbye to Gina, or Snowflake. This is her last day on trail. She heads back to New Zealand in a few days' time. It'll just be Chloe and I now moving forward from there. Cloud Reader, she's somewhere ahead. And Orange Man is somewhere behind, so we're sort of stuck in the middle. We may catch these guys again. Next stop will be Sierra City. Gotta go in there. All going well, I've got a parcel from New Zealand waiting for me. Thanks to my girlfriend. So that'd be awesome if that's arrived. And a couple of nights ago, my air mattress had a blowout. Took an exped, Sinmat. And yeah, the weld between two of the baffles went, so it's now got this huge raised bulge in it. Anyway, quick email and phone call to Exped USA, and they've got one on the way to Sierra City on FedEx, so it should arrive the same day we do. All going well, so that's absolutely incredible customer service from Exped. Didn't expect it to be dealt with so quickly, so it's awesome. So we just had something really, really cool happen, and we just bumped into friends here on the trail. Wizard and Dilly Dally. That's awesome. So we're at the Donner Ski Ranch, and this is where we part ways with Snowflake. Congratulations, you've done what, 1149 miles?
Just under 2,000
kilometres. Well done. So, and you're heading home in a couple of days' time. So, yeah. So it's just Chloe and I now. The tremolo reduces, but that's okay. We've had a good time. So here we are this morning on top of a hill. Here comes Queen of Hearts. That hill there, we camped near the top of last night. So we've walked down and along the valley and back up. So we've done 3.6 miles so far this morning, and just over an hour and a bit. So yeah, really, really nice walking conditions. The sun's not on us yet, so it hasn't got too hot. So we have achieved something this morning that we haven't done in ages.
Yeah. Oh, 10 miles by 10 o'clock.
In fact, by 9:30.
Whoop, whoop.
And right on that point we were going to stop for a break, it was trail magic. That's awesome.
It was amazing.
I forget their names. Couple of girls that we've been leapfrogging with the entire way. One of them, her name is Frodo. I can't remember the other, but anyway, her their dads have just turned up on trail, and they've been cooking breakfast for everybody coming through since Saturday. So that's freaking awesome.
It was such a nice treat. We had scrambled eggs with bacon and Gatorade. very happy and ready to hike on.
Exactly. Now we've got a belly full of eggs.
Yeah.
Let's go. We had a really awesome day today, done 22.4 miles. It was just awesome terrain.
Yeah, it was good. We got into camp about 4 o'clock, which is pretty nice because then we get to set up early and chill and get some stuff done.
And have a campfire. That's while we're having dinner. What do you got for dinner, Chloe?
I have Kung Pao chicken.
Nice. And of all things I'm eating is a backcountry cuisine or cooked breakfast.
Hello. So second breakfast time for us at 7 o'clock in the morning here, and we've done 5 miles. We've got 5 miles to go into Sierra City. We're going to do a resupply, hopefully have a shower and do some laundry, but that might be not on the cards, and then head back out for a 6 to 7 day stretch resupply. So we got woken up in the night about 5 to 1 by a bear. Do you want to tell them about that, Daniel?
Yeah, so I'm in my tent and I hear this sound like a tree being ripped to pieces. I think I heard it before Chloe, but yeah, pretty certain it was a bear. Didn't get out for a look. All we had to do was start talking to each other, and it stopped pretty soon after that. And so I imagine it hurt us and hightailed out of there. So what's for breakfast this morning, Chloe? Let me turn this thing around.
An Epic bar, protein bar. And I swapped a bar with Daniel. So I swapped a Cliff bar so I could have one of his Nutri-Grain bars.
That's so good. Yeah. That's my go-to breakfast.
Supply of these.
Yeah, I found a box of 48 of them in Mammoth ages ago for $8. And yep, me, Nutri-Grain bars and black coffee. So this is our view. Well, ain't that true? So we're in Sierra City and just collected our mail. This is exciting. Thank you, Jenna, for sending this.
Thank you, Jenna.
That is amazing.
Oh, ooh. Look how neat it all is.
Wow. First things first, the best New Zealand chocolate in the world, Whittaker's Fruit and Nut. Get to that in a moment. Cook breakfast, nasi goreng, Moroccan lamb stir fry, carrot cake and custard times two, Lindt chocolate, baked Odie slices, they are awesome, 1 square meals, cookie time, a heap of Snickers, and
Tim Tams.
Technically they're Australian, but they're still pretty good.
They are amazing.
That is awesome. Thank you so much. So here we are at the Pines Resort in Sierra City. An unexpected stop, but we get into Sierra City at 10 o'clock this morning and the power's out, so nothing's open.
Yeah, we waited like 5 hours and then I got hangry and tired.
So we've got a room here. It was pretty good price, and despite the lack of power, they still have cold beer.
And New Zealand wine.
Yes, New Zealand wine.
Such a nice treat.
Yep. So power cuts aside, here's our dinner. Good? Totally good.
Delicious.
Absolutely. We've all got pork chops. So just on the way out of Sierra City, climbing up the switchbacks here. I was currently sitting at Switchback Spring, which has got lovely, clear, cold water. My hat's wet because I just dunked it because it's hot today. Yeah, unexpected stop in Sierra City last night due to the power cut. It finally came on at about 7 p.m. So we stayed at the Pines. They were really, really good. They, despite the power outage, they got the barbecues out, and we're going to make sure no one went hungry, but then the power came on, so they got the restaurant going. And yeah, nice place to stay. We got back to the trail at about 10 a.m. after having breakfast at the Red Moose. But I go to make this video and the camera starts beeping. Memory card. I left it in the room, so, but thankfully there was a nice gentleman at the trailhead that ran me back down to the motel, and the cleaner had it sitting in her trolley, so I was relieved. My heart sank, because every video, every photo that I've taken is on that memory card right from the start, so I was, yeah, very, very, very relieved to be reunited with it. So yeah, not sure how many miles we're going to get today. We're a little bit behind schedule because it's nearly lunchtime now and we've only gone about 2 miles, but it's okay. We'll get the climb out of the road, get to the top, and see what the day brings. And yeah, tomorrow we'll get stuck in for a few more miles, I guess. So, but good to be back out here on trail. The only thing I've commented about Sierra City was the resupply. Yeah, it was not that great. Like, I'm all about supporting the wee stores in these trail towns, but it's hard when they don't have a lot. They had no oats, they had no potato chips, he had two flavours of ramen, lots of it. I think he had the biggest supply of Pop-Tarts I've ever seen though. But yeah, so if you're coming through here, say next year, I'd highly recommend sending a box to Sierra City. It's just perhaps not the most reliable resupply option. So yeah, the box that I showed earlier, if it weren't for that, I'd have been probably, yeah, I probably would have had a really crappy resupply, but it's okay. We'll be fine. So next stop is Chester, all going well. We should have enough food to get through to there in about six to six and a half days. So although it's a 3,000 foot odd climb, the views are worth it. It's amazing. Woohoo! 1,200 miles. So we just stopped for the second breakfast this morning after climbing a big hill straight out of camp. This was our view whilst we had breakfast. Not bad. And guess what? It's probably going to be another beautiful day. Fancy that. Here's a typical example of water that we get along the trail. And this one in particular, I've got to say, has got to be some of the cleanest, coldest water I've seen the whole way. It's really, really nice. So we just come from a road end where we bumped into trail angel named Anne. She had just arrived and she was delivering water. She probably delivered about 20, 30 gallons of water, and she had
Fizzy, which was really nice, and she had a stash of food for anyone that is quite low. Luckily enough, we didn't need any, but it's so lovely she thought of that and
put it handy. And she had two cool dog friends. We enjoyed dog friends.
Yeah.
That was great. Woohoo! 2,000 kilometres. That's a big deal. It doesn't seem like that long ago we crossed the 1,000 mark. These are my delightful looking feet. I've never seen them this dirty. That's disgusting. And even worse are my socks. She ain't glamorous out here, that's for sure. Don't know if you can see there, but right in the middle of the frame between the logs is a rattlesnake. We kind of want to camp here. We just need him to go away.
So despite the rattlesnake, we are all set up for dinner. I'm having, I think it's, I don't even know what to call this.
What'd you call it before though?
I've got the name wrong, like Kung Fu Chicken.
Kung Pao.
Kung, but yeah.
Close.
Yeah, so I've added more cashew nuts to make it appetizing. And I have a surplus, so I'm having dessert tonight. Doesn't it looks like baby food, it truly does, but it's freeze-dried carrot cake and custard.
One of our favourites.
Yeah, and I'm just about to tidy up my mess, and then Daniel told me I am a mess.
We both are.
So, just the mess around me I can only tidy.
Team Dirtbag.
Yeah.
Yep. And me, I am having Idaho mash and chipotle tuna. Haven't had tuna mash in a while, but I'm excited because it smells really good. And it's the good flavour, garlic and parmesan. Yay. Love it.
So Daniel, tell us about how you're filtering your water.
I'm not.
What are you doing?
I'm sterilising my water.
Very flash. Wait. How did you do that?
UV light. SteriPen.
Dun dun dun.
Yeah, I got.
Isn't it amazing?
I got tired of my Sawyer, so I brought this thing instead, and it's been much, much better.
So what do you do with it?
You turn it on and you put it in the water and it uses UV light and blasts all the bugs dead.
Nice.
Simple as that.
And it does it take long?
90 seconds for a litre.
Sweet.
Morning, so we're on our way up the climb out of Belden. We started yesterday on this thing, but it was crazy hot. So all up, it's about 14 miles of climbing, and it was 38 degrees Celsius when we left Belden, and trying to climb up this thing and that sort of temperature was just ridiculous. So we only went a few miles and then we camped. We're at least 4 miles to go to the top now. And tomorrow, late morning, we'll arrive into Chester. We will get a very much needed shower and laundry. I think this has been the dustiest, dirtiest section of the whole PCT so far. I don't think I've smelt this bad ever along the whole way. So yeah, much needed. Yes, we made it to the top. I swear that was the longest 14 miles of the whole trail so far. It was unreal.
It was a slog.
One heck of a slog. But yeah. Now we get to cruise along on top of the hill all day. That way, somewhere. Just coming through the meadow here and it's like butterflies for Africa. They are everywhere.
First time I've seen a bear, and it has not scared of me. That is not ideal.
So we've arrived in Chester. we got a hitch down here with a local highway patrol officer, so that was really quite nice. It was good having a chat to him, nice bloke. And we just had burgers for lunch at, I can't remember where we had lunch, that was ages ago, but we had lunch and anyway, it was double meat, double cheese, so it was really good. Anyway, we've just checked into a room and we're about to have showers, but we thought we'd show you quickly how dirty we are.
Yeah, I have never ever had this top, this stylish before.
Yeah, show us your back.
Yeah, and I've got stains all over my pants.
Yes, and I'm not much better. Look at all the sweat stains. It's disgusting. The water's going to run brown in the washing machine tonight. But check these bad boys out.
Oh, I don't know if I should show them.
I washed them last night. You wouldn't believe it.
Oh my gosh, it's so scary.
I know, right?